This is the fourth or final video on soft matter physics, focusing on liquid crystals. Liquid crystal consists of two words, liquid and crystal. A complete order material is a crystal and a disorder material is a liquid. This implies that liquid crystal refer to those materials that are in between these two phases, meaning liquid crystal behaves like a crystal but flow like a liquid. To better understand liquid crystal, we need to refresh our memory on the definition of order. First, orientational order. As name refers, if the individual constituents of material in average orient to some particular direction, be it be any direction, they have the orientational order. Second, translational order. It means if the constituent material in one column jumps to the next, for example towards right, then you cannot tell the difference after the action. Similarly, if they move up or down, the whole bunch looks the same. This means they have translational order. With this knowledge in our head, let's jump into the world of liquid crystals. In general, liquid crystals are divided into two types. First one goes with the name of pleiotropic. I know it might be a technical jargon word for you. What it simply says is that small particles suspended in the liquid might arrange themselves in some regular order. That means they act like a crystal. If so, they are called pleiotropic liquid crystals. Most of the time, such small particles are nanoparticles. But do you remember our colloid video? There we talked about colloidal particles can sometime also show the crystal behavior, named as colloidal crystal. That was it, the pleiotropic liquid crystals. If liquid crystal is pleiotropic, you can change its phase by changing the concentration of particles. Second type of liquid crystal goes with another technical jargon name, thermotropic. What are they? It might need a bit of room here, so let's start a clear screen to define the thermotropic liquid crystal. The word thermo in thermotropic gives you a sense that it is related with temperature. So let's draw a temperature line from lower temperature to way up to higher temperature. Remember our first discussion about liquid crystal? It falls in between crystal and liquids or isotropic materials. There will be our two points stated as melting point and clearing points. Here lies our very popular pneumatic liquid crystal. The constituents of pneumatic liquid crystals will orient in some direction but will lack the translational order property. So, if you remember from our previous discussions about orientational and translational order, it will just have orientational order. You might be thinking, can liquid crystal also have translational order? Yes. For this, you have to move a bit left in this diagram and look in between the crystal and pneumatic liquid crystal phase. They often go with the name of symmectic C and symmectic A. Yes, these crazy naming liquid crystals have both translational and orientational order. Here, if you move a bit left in the diagram, you will have other phases as well, with a bit higher degree of order. The point is, in thermotropic liquid crystal, you can jump from one liquid crystal to another liquid crystal, or in more fancy term, you can have a phase change by changing the temperature. Okay, this is all about microarchitecture of liquid crystals and their variety. But why is it important to know about the microarchitecture of liquid crystal and why liquid crystal are amazing? Well, most of it has to do with how liquid crystal interact with the light. Because of its tunable crystalline behavior, you can have liquid crystal which can do all sort of cool things. Cholestoric liquid crystal, which actually has not been discussed here, can reflect light of different colors or wavelength based on their pitch. And they are used for making mood ring, thermometers, and in some display units. Pneumatic liquid crystal can be tuned with the help of electric field from outside, which allows liquid crystal to be rich in the optical properties. They have been used in modern crystal display on cell phone, calculators, portable computers, and flat screen television. Liquid crystals are also used to polarize the light. As we discuss in other soft materials, the shape of microparticles forming liquid crystal does not necessarily has to be in a rod or cigar shape as I have been drawing. It comes in variety of shapes. Mother Nature has used liquid crystal in both plant and animal in fascinating ways. Especially the colors of different beetles are not from the pigment in their skin, whereas it comes from the liquid crystal shape of some molecule in them. Such color can fulfill different purposes. In some, it can attract their mating partner, whereas in others, it can help the insect to camouflage in the environment. Field of liquid crystal is fascinating and complex at the same time. This is the ending episode on soft matter physics series. I hope it was a good introductory lesson for high school and undergraduate students who are interested in soft matter physics. And also for others who are just curious on how actually is the soft materials look like and how scientists study them. As by now you might have realized, soft matter physics is interdisciplinary field. It is kind of like physicists tapping into the problems or complexities of chemistry and biology and addressing such complexities from the lenses of physics. Such an act has created a big and a diverse domain known as soft matter physics. Thank you for trekking with me in the landscape of soft matter physics for all along the 4 episodes. I hope it was a fun trek. See you next time.